Hey guys, how are you doing? All the students who wish to study in Canada, this video is for you. In this video, I will tell you a step-by-step process to study in your dream country. Canada's education is famous for its world-class standards, and studying in Canada is definitely a dream come true. So in this video, you will get to know the step-by-step process to study in your dream country. As getting a Canadian PR is getting increasingly difficult, immigrating to Canada after getting a study permit is probably the easiest way to settle down here. So if you're interested, don't go anywhere, I'll be right back. Okay, before I tell you the various steps involved in the complete process, it is important to understand the different intakes in Canada. Basically, there are three different intakes here in Canada. The first one is the September intake or the fall intake. This intake includes the most number of institutions offering the largest number of seats available in all the courses. You can say September intake is the main intake. Second intake starts few months after September in January, and it is called the January or the winter intake. This intake can be considered as a continuation of the fall intake. A fewer number of institutes offer courses in winter intake compared to the fall intake. Mostly the students who have missed the admission in fall intake would opt for this winter intake. Now the last one is the spring intake or the summer intake. This is also known as the May intake. This is the least preferred intake of all the intakes here in Canada that are available. Not many colleges offer a course during this spring session, and the ones that offer are very few. So, you now know that the main intake is the September intake, but there are other intakes as well. Okay, now when you know about all of these three different intakes, we can start discussing the different steps involved in the complete process. The first one is doing your own research. So it is very important that you do your research. Firstly, you should know that the entire process takes a lot of time. Starting from the first step to moving to Canada, it takes around 1 year time. Because it is one of the biggest decisions of your career, so you don't want to rush into taking any decisions. So you should start 1 year before when you want to start your studies here in Canada. So which points should you consider while doing your research? Number one, which course? You should be pretty sure about the course that you want to pursue here in your studies. You'll be required to finalize a specific major course when applying to study in Canada. The Canadian academic setup is quite flexible towards switching courses, although it is best to compare your options beforehand and choose a major that you truly are interested in pursuing. And while doing that, you should definitely make a point of its scope in Canada. When you're thinking of studying in Canada, most people, if not all, want to stay here, want to settle down here in Canada. So in your research, you should think of the scope of your studies. Is there a good scope of getting a job? What kind of package can you get after completing your studies? All those points should be kept in mind. Now, after that, it comes down to selecting your university or colleges. I would suggest you pen down few universities and colleges where you want to get admission. We would come to this point in the next step. Now, for those colleges and the universities that you have selected, you should know what are the exact requirements, and then only you would be able to prepare according to that. Now, even IELTS requirements are different for different colleges. Even the same college, for different courses, the IELTS requirements are different. So you should know that well in hand. Now you should also be aware of the cost. What would be the fee? How much money do you actually need in hand if you want to go ahead implementing your plan of studying in Canada? You should be aware of the funding sources. If you're getting that money from your parents, let them know well in advance that you would need that amount of money so that they're also prepared. And talking of funding sources, you can also search for scholarship programs. There are various scholarship programs that are being offered by the universities and colleges, so you should definitely check for those as well. And last but not the least, you should definitely think about the location and the campus. So if you want to live in a bigger city, let's say Toronto, in that case you should look for universities that are in the GTA region. if you want to live in more of a quiet city, you can look for universities and colleges in the Waterloo region. Maybe going even further north, you can check for the universities in London. And that I'm talking about just finding a college or a university while you are around the GTA region, the Greater Toronto Area. So basically, these are all the points that you should have in mind, that you should be pretty clear about in your research. Now let's talk about the second step. Okay, the next step is your language proficiency test. You must have heard about it, about the IELTS test. Not just IELTS, there are other tests as well. We'll talk about it. Now, while doing your research in the first step, you would get to know what are the exact requirements of the universities, of the colleges, and of the courses. It does differ from one college to the other and from one course in that same college to the other course. So basically, the language test can be taken either for English or for French. For English, we do have options. The first option is the most popular one, is the IELTS test. You have to go for the IELTS Academic, not the IELTS General. Remember, IELTS Academic is for studying and IELTS General is for immigration purpose if you want to get the PR. Okay, now next is TOEFL, which is also very famous. The other one is Cambridge English Advanced Test. Out of these three tests, IELTS is the most common and the most popular one. Apart from English test, you can also go for French tests like TEF, TCF, DALF or DELF. Okay, now talking of the criteria, you would see that most of the colleges and the universities actually ask for minimum of 6 bands of IELTS with no band less than 5.5, a TOEFL score of around 80. And a general criteria is 6.5 in IELTS with no band less than 6.0. Similarly, 88 score in TOEFL. So you have 4 different bands: listening, reading, speaking, and writing. So for the general criteria, in all those 4, you should not get less than 6. But as I told you, it does differ from one university to the other, from one college to the other. So you should definitely look for the exact requirement so that you have a goal clear in your mind that this is your requirement and this is what you have to get. If you could not achieve your goal in the first test, you can go for the other tests. There's no number limit and the fees for IELTS Academics is around 13 to 14,000 rupees in India. If you want to go for IELTS, you can either go through IDP India or you can also go for British Council. However, if you're living in any other country, you can definitely check the organizations and the fees and the dates accordingly. Okay, moving on to the third step, which is getting your acceptance letter. There are only 4 steps, so every step is crucial and this step is important as well. Because in this step, you will get that acceptance letter, which is the mandatory document for your study permit. Without an acceptance letter from any university or college, you cannot get the study permit. So this is the most important document and hence I've mentioned it as a separate step here. Now the acceptance letter must be from a DLI college. So while you're researching for the colleges or universities, you must make sure that those colleges and universities are designated learning institutions. DLI stands for designated learning institutions. If the college or the university is a designated learning institution, it would be mentioned very clearly on their website. Now the acceptance letter must state the program of study, including the start and the end dates. Now talking of applying to colleges or universities, I told in the first step that I will talk about it later, and so let's discuss it now. So how many colleges you should choose and how you should actually aim those colleges or universities. So you should not choose only one college and just think that you would get the acceptance letter from that college. Don't assume things. So to be on the safer side, select few colleges or universities. The first type should be from those dream colleges or universities where you actually dream to study. But getting admission in all the colleges and universities is not easy. So the second list or the plan B should be those colleges. And you know that the institution is really good. You would also get admission with your academic scores in that college pretty easily. So make a plan A and a plan B. And while doing your research in the step one, you would see that there are specific requirements for each colleges. So you should have the list of documents. There would be a fee for it. There could be a fee of around $100 or $200. So you just can't go on applying to each and every college, because obviously there's a fee and you should be very serious about it. You just can't waste your money like that. So which all documents would be required? So there would be a completed application form. You could get that form from the website or maybe through an email if you contact that college or the university. Then you would need to have an essay or a writing sample. Then you would need to have a statement of purpose, which is also very important. Obviously you need to include your language proficiency test report in that as well. You need to have a letter from the bank stating that the funds are available for study. You need to have an affidavit for financial support, maybe signed from your parents. You should have a transcript. Now this is very important. Please remember, getting a transcript is very important. So while doing your research, because these are all parallel activities, you can actually plan of getting a transcript from your college. So these are all the required documents, and once you apply to those colleges, hopefully you could get the acceptance letter from any one of them. Then you can move on to the fourth step. Okay, now coming over to the last point, fourth point, study visa application. So of course you need to apply the study visa or the study permit to come to Canada. You've got the acceptance letter, but that acceptance letter was for the sake of getting the study visa, and you can apply that online or you can apply that through your VFS office in your city. Okay, now the documents which are required. First of all, the acceptance letter. As I told you, it was the most important document. Then of course your passport, affidavit of your financial support, PCC, which is your police clearance certificate, and your medical test report. So you need to get your medical test done as well. So all of these documents are required. There may be a couple of other documents as well, but you will get to know as and when you apply that study permit. There is a fee for that study permit as well, and that is $150. However, the processing time differs a lot from one country to the other. The processing time can differ from 3 weeks to 12 weeks. Now, you might say that it's a big time range. Yes, definitely it is. However, 3 weeks is for the new program which was launched in 2018. It is called as SDS. If you want to know more about it, I made a separate video about it in detail. You can check it out. If you're in India, you can definitely apply through the SDS program and get your study permit in just 3 weeks time. Also, if you want to know about the effect of coronavirus or COVID-19 pandemic, you can find the link of that video in the description box below. Right, so once you're done with your study permit, after that it comes down to traveling. Now you have to plan your travel, because planning your travel is also very crucial. You should come to Canada 1 to 2 weeks before your session actually starts, because you have to manage your accommodation. If you're learning in winter season, then climate also plays a very crucial role. So that's it. That is the complete process to achieve your Canadian dream. So thank you guys for watching this video. I just hope that the content shared in this video would be helpful for you guys. If you have any queries, please put them down in the comment section below. Please like this video, share it with your friends. And yes, if you haven't subscribed my channel yet, please click the subscribe button, because I regularly make videos like these. Thanks again for watching this video.